Let's talk about how to calculate equivalent units. This example problem says Ericsson Company has the following production data for September. They have 25,000 units that were transferred out, and then in their ending work in process, they have 8,000 units that are 100% complete as to materials and 40% complete as to conversion costs. Now we need to determine the equivalent units of production for both materials and conversion costs. So how do we do that? Let's first focus on the equivalent units for materials. So what we will do is we'll take our units transferred out and then add in our ending work in process. Now for materials, we're told that our ending work in process is 100% complete as to materials. So we're going to add in all 8,000 of those units. So our equivalent units for materials will be 33,000. Now, equivalent units for conversion costs. It's going to be slightly different here. What we need to do is we need to consider that 40% that we're told. So we still take all 25,000 of the units that were transferred out. But then we add in 40% of our 8,000 units in our ending work in process. Because those 8,000 units are only 40% complete as to conversion costs. So when you take 40% of 8,000, you get 3,200. So our equivalent units for conversion costs would be 28,200. So now you can see your equivalent units for materials and for conversion costs.